What's up, my friends? This is Dustin with Electrician U. So today I had a pretty arduous day. This is gonna be a very quick video, not your usual Monday awesome video with lots of research and time put into stuff. This is a very quick video. So what I'm doing, let me flip this guy around. What I'm doing today, I replaced my service panel. Replaced my riser. There was like this crappy little riser down here before. Power was coming in here, was hooked up below the eave, so it wasn't even a, like, my point of attachment is below 10 feet, and my weatherhead was below that. So I had power company come out, disconnect power, rebuilt the service. This is a 1968 home, so everything that they ran was 12-3, so they've got all these multi-wire branch circuits everywhere, so it's really hard to arc fault protect any of that without getting $100 two-pole 20 arc fault breakers that you can share a neutral and actually have a shared neutral breaker. I didn't have any of those, you know, like this is, that would be $600, they're $100 a piece, so I just don't have them. I'm gonna try to get them. That way I can make sure everything's arc fault protected rather than going and putting in actual arc fault devices in every single room and every circuit. There are a couple of circuits that I did have singles, so I put arc fault protection on those. This is an outdoor circuit, so there's a GFCI on the house, doesn't need to be arc fault protected. But let me at least break through kind of what I did. Now, this is definitely not my prettiest work. This was me trying to film all day long. I had a GoPro strapped to my chest, battery kept dying every few hours. The memory cards would burn up, not burn up, but they would like fill up. I had another camera over here that kept filling up, so I was like battling the time constraints of having to do the work, get an inspection out here, get the power company to meet me first thing in the morning, disconnect power, have them come back out, reconnect power, do all of that stuff that we normally do as electricians, but also try to film it all and create content and from multiple different cameras. It was just like an arduous day. It sucked. You know, once I got in here, I realized like all my neutrals were way too short. All my grounds were way too short. And I'm like, shit. So my option is to try to put a whole bunch of wire nuts and extend all of these wires up there. And that's just gonna look like dog shit. You know, you're gonna have like piles of wire nuts over here. So rather than doing that, I just put this ground bus in here. This is a service panel, so we're already bonded anyways. We're bonded to the can, and all of our neutrals and grounds are bonded. So all I did was I ran a bonding jumper that's sized appropriately and for this application. It'll hold the load for all of these neutrals. Ran a bonding jumper so that we're conductor dependent. If there's a fault that happens, or if there's a short circuit that happens on one of these neutrals, we're not using the can as our path for ground fault current to travel back to the neutral. We actually have a number 6 THHN conductor. And I did the same thing for the grounds. The grounds were all way too short. Rather than using the can itself that's bonded to the neutral as the way for ground fault current to travel back to that neutral, I would rather have a conductor dependent ground fault path. So I ran a conductor up there. So both of my ground bars are conductor dependent, bonded at the actual bus rather than traveling through the can itself. So what we've got, this is my inspection list. I still don't have the power company out here, but I figure let's look at this a little bit, see if y'all can judge me. This is my point of attachment right now. 10 feet is actually like right here. So this is below 10 feet. So these are live conductors right here. I've got A phase, B phase, and neutral. This thing's gonna actually come off and it's gonna hook to my new point of attachment right there on the riser. And then the new conductors I left long just because if you look at this, it's real tight. They did leave a loop up there, but that loop is more for tension. It's not for them to have spare conductor. The PEC or the power company guy this morning was just like, if anything, if you could move the service over a little bit so that we don't lose any conductor when you're extending the length, please do that. But I couldn't because I have conductors already coming out of the wall, so I really couldn't move anything. So I just did him a favor. I added length to these, left a little bit extra for him. But we've got our weatherhead, 12.5 feet. This is above 10 feet point of attachment. It can be more than 10 feet. It doesn't have to be at 10 feet. It just needs to be more than that. So any, you know, traffic or anything doesn't hit their head on it. Right now, this is super low. I think this is hanging at right about 10 feet. All right, so then we've got our rigid pipe. It's 2-inch. This is a new 200 amp service. Before it was 125 amps. We're strapped within 30 inches every 10 feet. We've got our meter, incoming power. We've got a neutral coming in. This is not a floating neutral situation where there's plastic back here. This neutral is actually bonding the can because of this piece of metal. So I don't need to run a ground conductor in here, and our utility doesn't let us do that anyways. So the one thing they do want us to do is put a bonding bushing, so that way the nipple itself is bonded. So I run a bonding jumper to that bonding bushing, bonds the entire nipple, comes all the way back up, and it goes to our bonded neutral and ground. Inside, I've got my threaded bushings on everything. We got conductors that go in. Everything is torqued to make sure that I have torque specs, that I meet my manufacturer torque specs. That's an important thing to do. Like I said earlier, I've got a neutral extension, neutral bus that is conductor dependent, bonded, ground bus, conductor dependent, bonded, surge protector. That's new 2020 code. I've got all of my two pole breakers. The only thing I should do is make sure that they're arc fault protected, and I'm going to in a later video. This is just to get power on, so this passed inspection the way that it is. Make sure that you've got common handle ties, because these are 220s. These are all not 220s. These are all 120 volt multi-wire branch circuits.
Hey!
This is a 220 load. So anyways, this will pass inspection. The remaining 120 volt circuits are arc fault protected. This is a GFCI breaker, or this is a breaker for an outdoor GFCI circuit. So I have a GFCI out in the field, so it doesn't need to be a GFCI breaker itself. I've got my slab ground in here, so my grounding electrode is actually my slab. Grounding electrode conductor is coming up. It's a solid number 6. I think I'm good to go. I don't think there's anything that I missed on the inspection. My inspection checklist. My inspector said everything's good to go, so. That's your video for today. Sorry that it's not more comprehensive, but I will put more content out in a little while that goes over this a little bit more in detail, shows with the GoPro how I'm doing everything and what I'm doing.